राम राम सारे भाइयों ने और मेरी बहनों ने। माईसेल्फ देवेंद्र प्रताप सिंह एंड आई एम अ ड्रग्स इंस्पेक्टर एंड मेडिकल डिवाइसेस ऑफिसर अंडर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। एक्चुअली काफ़ी लंबा समय हो चुका है, लॉट अ बिग टाइम हैज बीन पास्ड एंड आई हैवंट मेक अ वीडियो सिंस अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम। अ लॉट ऑफ माय ऑडियंस आर वेटिंग फॉर माय वीडियो एंड आई एम रियली रियली वेरी सॉरी फॉर दैट कि आई एम नॉट एबल टू स्पेयर माय टाइम फॉर मेकिंग वीडियोस जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द ऑफिस वर्कलोड इज ट्रेमेंडस एंड इट्स इनॉर्मस इन साइज राइट नाउ। एक्चुअली टुडे इज इवन आई एम नॉट प्लानिंग अ वीडियो and sorry for that, I forgot my mic and headphone at my home. Actually I am traveling since 6 a.m. because I have a audit in Rajasthan, so I am driving right now. So and usually what happen nowadays, actually I am not traveling alone, so due to that reason I am traveling with somebody, my colleague and something like that. So due to that reason I am not even making videos while traveling, while driving. Usually what happen when I'm driving, I can easily able to communicate because I put my phone in my stand and then I'll able to talk and clear all the doubts and whatever the news is and what are the comments I am getting on my videos and all. I generally read those comments, even now I am reading it, but still there are a lot to answer and some of the people are really very confused about it and some confusions might be cleared it out. Okay, and a lot of questions which I am looking after to answer, and I am planning a video on this weekend. I will try my level best. Yeah, I'll make a video to clear all your doubts. Okay, so it's my humble request. I'll try to upload this video today, or today is 8th of February is today. I'll try my level best to upload this video on 8th of Feb. In tonight, and whatever questions you have, matlab genuinely what questions you have, drop your question in the comment section in that video. I will try my level best whenever I'll come back from the work, and I will answer all those questions. The view is so incredible, I never been seen. Rajasthan is that good. A lot of mountains right now in front of me. मैं राजस्थान को एक्चुअली सिर्फ डेजर्ट समझता था. लोग बोलते हैं ना, एक परसेप्शन बना हुआ हमारा कि राजस्थान इज ऑल अबाउट डेजर्ट. The view is just incredible. I am not even it's so mesmerizing. मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है मैं उत्तराखंड में आ गया हूँ. If this is Rajasthan, I am in love with Rajasthan. तो राजस्थान से कौन कौन है नीचे कमेंट्स में जरूर बता देना. तो एक्चुअली क्या है कि there are lot of questions people are having and lot of doubts which people are having. तो जैसे कि मैं अभी बता देता हूँ कुछ रिसेंट अपडेट हैं जो मैं आपको देना चाहूंगा, और एक दो अभी रिसेंटली क्वेश्चन मेरे से पूछे गए हैं जो आई गेस जरूरी है बता देना, वो जरूरी लगता है मुझे. तो उन चीजों के लिए मैं आपको आंसर करना चाहूंगा कि मैं सबसे पहला अभी यूपीएससी पर एक रिजल्ट पब्लिश हुआ है जिसमें क्या कहते हैं हमारा जो रिक्रूटमेंट 2016 वाला हुआ था उसमें कुछ लोगों का सिलेक्शन अभी यूपीएससी ने किया है. एक्चुअली क्या था उस टाइम पर जब हमारा सिलेक्शन हुआ था, देर आर लॉट ऑफ कैंडिडेट्स हु हैव मेड अ कोर्ट केस बिकॉज ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इश्यूज. काफी सारे लोगों ने वहाँ कोर्ट केस किया था. जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट कोर्ट केस यूपीएससी अलाउड देम टू अपियर इन द इंटरव्यू एंड दे गेव देयर इंटरव्यू एंड द रिजल्ट हैज बीन होल्ड टिल डेट. वो रिजल्ट अभी तक होल्ड रहा और अब वो जाके कोर्ट में केस जीते हैं. दे विन देयर केस इन द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ एंड बेस्ड ऑन द जजमेंट प्रोवाइडेड बाय द सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया यूपीएससी हैज टू कंसिडर देयर application whatever the interview it is and based on the interview merit they have shortlisted some candidates. So among them I guess 30-40 candidates has been selected. A lot of candidates are assistant drugs inspector still in my department and some of them are my colleague as well. Some of the assistant drug inspector who are selected are the junior batch of mine. So I am really very happy ki the people with whom I am working since so long are being right now anyhow got a chance to become a drugs inspector because their promotion is even pending since so long and this is really very good for them ki they'll become a drugs inspector and it's really good for their life as well. So that UPSC result is for that only. Okay, so that's why I always says ki whenever you are appearing in an interview and your any candidate wala selections aapka kisi bhi due to some sort of reasons they are cancelling your candidature, you must make a court case because if you make a court case you'll always get a chance to appear in an interview you always have a chance to participate whatever activities UPSC are being UPSC will conducted in the future as well. So you always be qualified. If you make a court case, if you will not make a court case, they will not call you for interview and all that. If they asking for any experience and you don't, you think that you have experience, but that experience is not what UPSC is asking. Still, you have some sort of experience. Just make a court case, because I said na, a lot of the state allowed fresher candidates to appear in the interview. The point is what? I'll never recommend that UPSC will allow selection of freshers as a drugs inspector, because in my opinion, I'm just sharing my opinion, okay? This opinion might be harsh actually, but what I mean to say is this job is not for a sake purpose. This job is to ensure the quality, safety, efficacy of medicine. This is a matter of public safety. And the if the fresher candidates are selecting by the UPSC for a such post, they'll not able to perform their job in the duty, because the people whom you are going to face in the industry are very talented, very educated, very well sound. And we people, we as a fresher, I must say ki hardly 1% of that population who are studying in a B-Pharm are that much sound population who knows the basic principles of the testing, manufacturing and all these stuff. So in my opinion, if you ask me, UPSC will cancel the experience or what, so I'll never recommend UPSC to delete the experience clause, because the quality of inspector will be so devastating. We are comparing ourselves with the US FDA and MEA, but trust me, if this will happen, and actually this will happen, what I guess 99.9% is already is almost the experience will be deleted from the recruitment rules of the drugs inspector in central government as well. But I am not sure, until and unless the publication will not come in force, I am not assure you ki whether the experience is being cancelled or not. So everything is depend upon when the UPSC will publish the publication for the latest upcoming vacancy for the drugs inspector. So in my opinion, that experience should remain there, because the quality of inspector will be so poor. What people are studying in B-Pharm is very discouraging, actually. Very, very discouraging, because I received a lot of comments on my videos and they asked me, sir, how to check on which website the vacancy will come? And I have answered all of them. You have to Google it UPSC, you have to Google it Public Service Commission, and you will just put the name of state and you will get all the results. So they keeps asking me, ki sir, please send us the link, exact link where it is come. Actually, you'll just think about it. If they people are not able to find where the recruitment will come, how they can able to read some technical documents like WHO TRS and all, which is available on the WHO website. And the website is itself is very ambiguous and a very huge website, and there is a huge collection of data on the WHO and US FDA website. If they have to find a TRS, technical report series, that is the full form actually. So if they have to find a TRS to study about the basic principles of GMP, GLP, GCP, all the concepts. So how they'll able to find out? I am not even saying ki how to read. Actually, the point is how to find out. So this is a very serious concern. If UPSC will abolish that experience clause, the quality of inspectors are really very poor. And I don't like to see that ki inspector who are going to an industry, to a good industry, and when the industry technical people will ask some question, and they'll not able to answer it. And even the inspector is going for audit or something to audit that company, pharmaceutical company, and they have no question to ask, because they are not aware about the basic principle and methodology of the processes which is being carried out for the manufacturing testing of that particular drug. Either it is a solid dosage form, either it is a semi-solid dosage form, it is a parenteral dosage form, whatever the dosage form it is, because nowadays the medicine culture is evolved so much, the science and technology is so much advanced, like na So if they are not technically sound, we gonna face a lot of challenge while doing audits and all, because this will ultimately will spoil the image of the department and organization, even the government officer image as of now as well. If we are comparing ourselves with the USFDA, with the TGA and MHA, then we'll know that still the quality of the inspectors are not par to that level. So if the experience clause is being abolished, I know this is a very harsh, and I really don't mean to say that. I am sorry for offending people who are not having experience right now, but I literally recommend you, and I must wish you, just after completing your BPharm, if you are not going to pursue your master's, just please get it some job in a company as an intern. Don't think about money, okay? I know in our age it is a very difficult time to how to manage things, but if in that time if you will not able to sacrifice some luxury of your life, then you will not able to make it. Because I know in my time I have done a lot of hard work in my initial days, how I have lived my and how I have survived. So the thing is ki you have to work hard a lot, get a job in a schedule C1 drug and do the testing. Because in BPharm you are not even, some of the colleges in our India, they are not even allowing their students to touch the big equipments like HPLC, quality equipments like HPLC. Some of the graduate student, BPharm student, done their BPharm without even touching the UV spectrophotometer. They don't even know how to calibrate the UV spectrophotometer. They don't even know how to calibrate the HPLC. You ask these questions by yourself. Ki you are done your BPharm. Do you know how to calibrate the UV spectrophotometer? How to calibrate HPLC? Which column is basically used for what purpose? You know the meaning of that. These are the very basic thing. I'm not even jumping ahead if I'll ask you how the XRD machine will work, because in a BPharm we don't even know what XRD is. XRD is the X-ray diffraction machine, okay, and how the particle size is to be conducted by the machine, particle size counter, a lot of machine is there. How the granulation is being done, there are various type of granulation techniques by which the granules are prepared, which are used for the final formation of the tablet. So there are a lot of things which you must know before being a drugs inspector. If you are not, because just by reading a book you are not supposed to be a good enough to handle all these things in the actual field while you are doing the work. So my humble suggestion or humble request to each one of you who have done your BPharm or about to done your BPharm, don't wait for the recruitment or just preparing for the exam. Get a job first, and while doing a job keep preparing, because a 2-3 hour study even while you are into the job is quite enough, okay? Because if you have a sound fit mind and you have a sound fit clarity in your vision, and you are technically sound, then you will be able to answer in the UPSC interview as well. Because a lot of candidates who are not being selected are just because they have no practical experience. The candidates who have some sort of experience, like they have done a good job while doing the testing on HPLC and UV, and a lot of technical experts who are sitting in the panel of UPSC will ask you which equipment you have handled in your college. So you will say, yes sir, I have handled HPLC. They'll ask you a lot of question about HPLC, how you have calibrated, what is reference standard, what is working standard, what is this column, why this column is being used, if this molecule has to be identified by using the HPLC, which column you will prefer. A lot of such questions will examiner will ask you, interviewer will ask you, and a person who has been worked good enough in a BPharm in a college level, then they'll be able to answer it. But I guess 99% of the candidates will not able to answer it because they have not done anything on the HPLC, UPLC. There are a lot of equipment like that. So if you have not done any work on it, you will not even able to think about it, what to answer, because theoretical knowledge is nothing. If they'll ask a technical question in depth about how the practically it is being done, so the theoretical always fails, because those panelists who will ask question are very technically sound and have a huge 20-25 years of experience being in the field. So you're not able to answer all these questions. So my humble and very first suggestion is to, just after completing your B-Farm, if you are not planning your M-Farm, Masters, then please get a job in Schedule CC1. And what is Schedule CC1? I have already answered in so many videos. Basically, those are the parenteral products. Either if it is a small volume parenteral, either it is a large volume parenterals, vitamins and all these injectable kind of forms, all these comes under the Schedule C1, a lot of antibiotics. So you will work in any of the company who deal with any of a product, okay? And get a job first, and this will really help you a lot, okay? Sorry, I will upload this video raw as such because I don't have a time to edit this. And just speaking so loud because I don't have a mic and you know, इतना बोलने की आदत है, but थोड़ा ज़्यादा तेज़ बोलना पड़ रहा है, तो just kindly bear all these things, okay? अगर मैं properly video edit करता, तो then definitely I'll cut this section, but today I'll not able to do it, so please forgive me for this. So this is the thing. कि रिक्रूटमेंट वाला सीन कि जो यूपीएससी पर रिजल्ट आया है वो किस चीज से है, क्या है, ठीक है ना? तो वो एक्सपीरियंस से रिलेटेड था. दे हैव मेड केस एंड दे हैव वॉन एंड अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल दे हैव ऑलरेडी हैव सम सॉर्ट ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस बट यूपीएससी हैव नॉट कंसीडर्ड देयर एक्सपीरियंस एंड ड्यू टू दैट दैट केस एंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स हैपेंस. तो फाइनली द इश्यूज हैज बीन रिजॉल्वड. दे ऑल हैज बीन सिलेक्टेड. ऑलमोस्ट 147 ऑफ द बैच इज राइट नाउ इज इन द डिपार्टमेंट बिकॉज सम पीपल हैव क्विट देयर जॉब. And those seats were also vacant in the department, and now they have selected almost those number of candidates which are being empty in the department. So now it's all 147 is now is in full strength. So it is a good thing because a lot of promotion has been done in past few months, and a lot of ADC has been newly, it's not called newly, they are already working as a drugs inspector, now they are working as an assistant drugs inspector, assistant drug controller. And so there are lack and there is shortage of drugs inspector in the department right now. Literally this is a very huge shortage of the inspectorate staff in the department right now. And by this result, it is really very helpful ki some inspector will come and join in the department, and it will really ease for us, each one of us. So this issue is, I guess, is being sorted out. सबसे पहली चीज यहाँ ये पूरी हो जाती है. दूसरा मैं आपसे बात करूंगा महाराष्ट्र एफडीए के बारे में. महाराष्ट्र एफडीए में करीब ना 70-80 से लेके 100 वैकेंसी तक आएंगी ड्रग्स इंस्पेक्टर की. पिछली टाइम वो एडवर्टीजमेंट आया था, पीपल वेंट टू कोर्ट एंड उसके बाद वो सब कैंसिल हो गया था. तो अब वो शायद वापस से आने वाला है. जैसे ही आएगा नजर में मुझे पता लगेगा, आई इन्फॉर्म यू ऑल एंड विल ट्राई टू मेक अ वीडियो. जब वो आएगा उसके लिए मैं टाइम निकाल के एक वीडियो तो बना ही दूंगा, एटलीस्ट सिलेबस जैसा भी रहेगा, जो भी रहेगा. अब बात ये आती है कि वो महाराष्ट्र वाला एफडीए का जो एग्जाम होने वाला है उसके अंदर ऑल ओवर इंडिया के कैंडिडेट्स अप्लाई कर सकते हैं या नहीं कर सकते हैं, ये सबसे बड़ा क्वेश्चन है. इसके बारे में कोई क्लैरिटी नहीं है. जब तक रिक्रूटमेंट का नोटिस नहीं आ जाता, ये बात नहीं पता लग सकती कि सबको अलाउ किया जाएगा या नहीं किया जाएगा. तो जैसा भी रहेगा आपको बताया जाएगा. आई विल टेल यू कि व्हेन द महाराष्ट्र एफडीए वैकेंसी विल कम फॉर द पोस्ट ऑफ ड्रग्स इंस्पेक्टर. आई विल टेल ईच वन ऑफ यू वेदर ऑल इंडिया कैंडिडेट्स आर एलिजिबल टू अप्लाई और नॉट. एंड द वेरी फॉरमोस्ट थिंग, बिकॉज इन द महाराष्ट्र द मैंडेटरी लैंग्वेज इज महाराष्ट्रियन लैंग्वेज, मराठी आई गेस. सो इफ द लैंग्वेज क्लॉज विल बी देयर, तो देर आर लिटरली वेरी लिमिटेड चांसेस की दे विल अलाउ ऑल इंडिया कैंडिडेट्स. बट फॉर अ पोस्ट ऑफ I sorted in my mind because there is a post of assistant commissioner in the Maharashtra FDA and a lot of people has been applied. I just remembered in my mind those all people are belong from the Maharashtra state. Some of them I know who have been appeared in the exam, then so called they have done the interview. The final result is awaited yet. So they have been selected. So final result is awaited that for the assistant commissioner post. So just sort of confusion. I don't know ki whether they will allow the all India candidate or not, but when the advertisement will come, it will be clarified in detail. So then only we'll able to know ki whether what will happen. But I will try my level best to ask this question from the previous year's selections from the inspectors who are already working in the Maharashtra FDA. I will ask them and then get back to you. एंड द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज कि गुजरात एफडीए का क्या सिलेबस आ गया है, जाके वेबसाइट से चेक कर लेना उनके, ठीक है ना। मेरे पास लिटरली अभी टाइम इतना नहीं होगा कि मैं निकाल के डाउनलोड करके लिंक विंक आई कैन प्रोवाइड यू। यू गाइस आर वेल स्मार्ट, जस्ट द पॉइंट इज आप अपडेट रहिए इन सारी चीजों से व्हेन एवरीथिंग इज बीइंग कम इन टू योर माइंड। सो जस्ट गेट टू द वेबसाइट एंड गेट द सिलेबस एंड प्रिपेयर। मुझे तो ये पता लगा था कि दैट एग्जाम वाज कैंसल्ड सम सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग, बट इफ दे हैव पब्लिश देयर सिलेबस और ऑल देन दे विल कंडक्ट द एग्जाम। सो डू प्रिपेयर अकॉर्डिंगली। और अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर आस्किंग कि हाउ मेनी मैथ्स क्वेश्चन विल कम इन द एग्जाम, बिकॉज इन एमपीएससी एग्जाम दे हैव आस्क्ड सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स। तो मैं आपको एक बात बताता हूँ, इट इज नॉट सर्टेन एंड इट इज नॉट डेफिनेट कि फ्रॉम विच सब्जेक्ट हाउ मेनी क्वेश्चंस विल कम। इट्स ऑल अपॉन द पैनल हु हैव सेट द क्वेश्चन पेपर, इट्स एवरीथिंग इज डिपेंड ऑन दोज पीपल हु आर बीइंग सिलेक्टेड फॉर मेकिंग दैट क्वेश्चन पेपर, बिकॉज अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चन विल कम फ्रॉम फार्मास्यूटिक्स, समटाइम्स अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चन विल कम फ्रॉम द फार्माकोलॉजी, लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चन समटाइम्स कम्स फ्रॉम द बायोकेमिस्ट्री एज वेल, and a lot of questions sometimes comes from the pharmacognosy as well. So it is not certain and it is not definitely from which subject how many questions will come, but for UPSC it is quite a bit certain for a reasoning and math kind of thing, not too much questions will come, 4-5 questions will come. The major subjects for UPSC drugs inspector exam will always be the pharmaceutics, chemistry, when I am saying chemistry, all sort of chemistry, inorganic, organic, medicinal, every chemistry will come in the chemistry part, pharmacology and pharmacognosy and drugs and cosmetic act. These are the major subjects from which the maximum number of questions will be asked. So prepare these subjects thoroughly and don't skip a single thing, because syllabus is important. You very well know about the syllabus and how you have to study. Prepare a plan and do things like that. Okay. And इसके बाद अब हम आते हैं, किसी का कोई डाउट है मुझे ड्राइव करते करते याद नहीं आ रहा, बिकॉज मैं बहुत कंडेंस रोड पे आ चुका हूँ, ये विलेज आ गया है यहाँ पर, शायद इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया माइट कम एंड माय प्रमाइसेस विल अबाउट टू कम। तो मैं कोशिश भी करूँगा इसको जल्दी कंक्लूड करूँ, बट हाँ आपसे मैंने अभी बोला कि जिसके जितने भी डाउट्स हैं क्वेश्चन हैं इस वीडियो के नीचे प्लीज पोस्ट कर देना। मैं कोशिश करूंगा जल्दी वीडियो बनाने की, जैसे ही यहाँ से काम निपटा के वापस आता हूँ मैं, आई गेस आई विल बैक ऑन सैटरडे इवनिंग। तो वंस आई विल कम बैक, उसके बाद मैं आपका करता हूँ, ठीक है ना। एक सेकंड रुकना, एक कॉल ले लेता हूँ, घर से फोन आया। हेलो, मैं 5 मिनट में फोन कर रहा हूँ, रुको जरा, मैं 5 मिनट में फोन करता हूँ। So the point is, whatever doubts you have in your mind, just ask them, shoot them in the comment of the video, and we will talk about it and we'll discuss about it, whether what doubts you have. और बाकी अभी एक बात जो सबसे पहले ये पूछ रहे हैं कि यूपीएससी का रिक्रूटमेंट का नोटिस कब आएगा, वो 2024 में ही आना है, और वो कब आएगा ये सर्टेन नहीं है, माइट बी मेरे हिसाब से बाय द एंड ऑफ ईयर ही आएगा, अक्टूबर में या फिर हो सकता है अगस्त सितंबर, या अगर गया तो वो दिसंबर तक भी जा सकता है, लास्ट में आएगा भी नहीं आने वाला है। तो तैयारी अपनी उस हिसाब से करते रहिए, और आई गेस लेट जितना आएगा उतना अच्छा है, क्योंकि लेट आएगा तो जो बच्चों के एग्जाम दूस कैंडिडेट्स विल बी कम्प्लीटिंग देयर बी फॉर्म बाय दिस ईयर, देर इवन एबल टू एलिजिबल टू अप्लाई इफ द रिक्रूटमेंट विल कम राइट नाउ। The current people who are in the B Farm 4th year will not able to apply. तो जो भी B Farm 4th year में currently पढ़ रहा है, shoot a comment कौन कौन B Farm 4th year में, और वो चाहता है कि अभी advertisement ना आए, because अगर अभी आ गया तो he'll not able to apply. But if it will come after, I guess, October, December might say, तो you guys able to apply. तो वो कौन कौन B Farm 4th year का candidate है जो चाहता है कि रिक्रूटमेंट का नोटिस दिसंबर तक आए, और बहुत सारे लोग जो बी फॉर्म करके बैठे हुए हैं, दे मस्ट विश कि इट विल कम एज सून एज पॉसिबल। तो आई एम वेल विशर फॉर ईच वन ऑफ यू, आई विश यू ऑल विल बी वर्क हार्ड सो मच, एंड मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ पीपल हुम आई नो पर्सनली ऑन दिस सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म विल बी सिलेक्टेड। आई एम रियली वेरी ग्लैड जब मुझे लोग बोलते हैं कि सर आई हैव बीन सिलेक्टेड, एंड रियली वेरी थैंकफुल फॉर यू फॉर गाइडिंग मी एंड फॉर लाइटिंग सम insight how I have to prepare for my exam. Now, sir, please help me for the interview. I really feel very good because to being a part, each one of your life is a really very incredible sort of experience because I've never been like this and I've never been in touch with so many people and sharing my experiences with you and learning a lot from you guys as well. A lot of you will ask so good questions from me. Even books are something like, na, in ACT, there are a lot of things which you get to know when you are keep reading and when you are actually keep practicing. And this law is very complicated. Unless you are not practically implementing in your practical life, you will not able to get clarity. Some of the people will really ask so many good questions and I'll discuss those questions with my colleague. They will get back to me. I'm not like an expert of a law, okay? I know something, people know something, we'll talk something, we'll discuss something, we'll grab something and we'll generate some practical and authentic sort of information. That information I like to give you so that you'll able to know ki what is the actual status of the and what is the actual meaning of that particular law. Whatever doubts you have, shoot in the comments. I'll try to answer each one of your question, but please don't ask repeated question. और प्लीज़ वीडियो को पूरा देखा कीजिए. मैं काफ़ी सारी बातें बोलता हूँ और मेरा गले में भी दर्द हो जाता है बोलते बोलते कई बार. बट अ लॉट ऑफ यू कीप आस्किंग मी यूजलेस क्वेश्चंस विच ऑलरेडी बीइंग आंसर्ड इन ऑल ऑफ माय वीडियोस एंड सम पीपल आर रियली वेरी गुड. दैट इज द पॉइंट ऑफ कंसर्न. दूस पीपल हु आस्क जेन्युइनली राइट क्वेश्चंस आर द कैंडिडेट्स हु गोना सेलेक्ट इन द बाय ऑल दीज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ईदर इट इज अ UPSC, ईदर इट इज अ PSC. यू विल जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट. You don't even have a patience to watch a 20-25 minutes video without skipping the content. Just you want to extract a content of that video in a 5 minutes span of time. Whatever I am speaking in a 25 minutes, you are thinking that I can get all the information which is in the 25 minute video in a 5 minute. Then my dear friends, it is not possible, because if it is possible for me, I really wish ki I can able to make that 5 minute video. Like now I am speaking from last 27 minute and I have a lot to speak and I have a lot to spoke. A lot of things I need to address to you guys, but just because the lack of time and the availability of the and the time and basically the circumstances in which I am right now currently are not allowing me to talk much more right now. So that's why I wish you all the very best. Work hard, अच्छे से पढ़ाई करो आप सारे के सारे. I'm really very happy for you, for those have been selected in the Delhi Drug Inspector exam and MPSC exam and all these exams. I'm really very happy and I wish you all the very best. सारे अच्छे से select हो. मैं सबका एक बहुत अच्छा meetup रखने वाला हूँ जब select हो जाएगा जो candidate, and I'll give party from my side. मैं सबको party दूंगा जितने भी लोग select होने वाले हैं, and I'll invite you on my call. I will make a group. सबके नंबर लूंगा मैं जो भी सिलेक्ट होने वाले हैं, और वो सारे स्टूडेंट्स जो जितने भी सिलेक्ट होने वाले हैं, दो स्टूडेंट्स विल ऑलवेज रिमेन अ पार्ट ऑफ माय फैमिली, ओके? एंड आई रियली फील सो गुड अबाउट इट. दिस इज अ इनक्रेडिबल एक्सपीरियंस, वन ऑफ द इनक्रेडिबल एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ माय लाइफ. सो आई एम रियली वेरी थैंकफुल ईच वन ऑफ यू इज बीइंग कनेक्टेड विद मी सिंस सो लॉन्ग, एंड आई रियली एडमायर योर पेशेंस बिकॉज आई हैवंट पोस्टेड अ वीडियो सिंस ऑलमोस्ट आई गेस 90 डेज. This video will come to you today, and I hope this will be a surprise for you. You sir have posted a video, and this is good. So shoot all the comments, whatever doubts you have, I'll try to address all these things. And I almost reached, about to reach, and so I will. I right now I must conclude the video, and we'll see each one of you very soon again. While answering your doubts and all, तो इस वीडियो को आप यहीं ख़त्म कर देते हैं और मिलते हैं आपने नए वीडियो के साथ जिसमें हम आपके सारे डाउट्स और चीज़ों को डिस्कस करने वाले हैं. तो आप ज़रूर डाल दीजिएगा. हैव अ गुड डे. बाय बाय. जय हिंद.